Oh, so glad to be here. We are Skillet. Thank you for coming to Winter Jam. Thank you for staying nice and late and watching us play. I appreciate it so much. We are Skillet. We have a brand new album out, and it's called Dominion. I've had a lot of people say, John. That's my name. Thank you, whoever that was. Your voice is going to hurt tomorrow, and I love it. Say, John, why'd you name your album Dominion? Listen, because it sounds awesome. But there's another reason I call this record Dominion, because I think after the last few years we've had, I think the earth, everybody in the earth, needs to be reminded exactly who owns this world up in here. And I got a message for you tonight. This world is not owned by a virus. This world is not owned by a pandemic. It's not owned by fear. It is not owned by Hollywood, celebrities, influencers, rock stars, pop music stars, big tech, big media, politicians. This world is not owned by the devil. It is not owned by demonic forces. This world is not owned by any president of the United States ever. Ever. This world is owned and ruled by one person, the King of Kings, the Lord of Lords, Jesus Christ, who is the ruler of the kings of all the earth. And that is why, in the middle of pandemics, and in the middle of death, in the middle of wars, rumors of wars, things that are a little bit frightening that we don't know how it's going to play out. Inflation, hatred, anger. Yes, in the middle of all these things, we are not shaken. Because if we are in Jesus Christ, if we are in Jesus Christ, then guess what? For every one of you that knows Jesus, this is what the Bible says to you. I did not give you a spirit of fear, but of power, love, and a sound mind, the Bible says. So even though we don't know what this year holds, we don't know if this year is going to be better than last, worse than last, life or death. What we know is this: if you are firmly planted in Jesus Christ, then you are safe. You are unshakable, because his word never fails. This song is called Anchor. We'll be right back. Check it out. If you love the music, do me a favor and tell a friend about our new album. Can you do that? Woo! I said, can you do that for me? Woo! Brand new song. This is called Dominion. Somebody say, yeah.
Yeah.
How many people have never seen Skillet play before? Never.
Just me, not you.
Just me.
Look at him.
What's wrong with you people? I thought for sure 90% of the hands were going to go off. Listen, all you first timers, I love you. You know I do. How many people have seen Skillet at least one time, or maybe 30, like some of my friends over here? Man, is it good to be back playing live music again? Woo! I love it. How many people think that, Lord willing, we probably are on the back end of this pandemic? I do too. Well, it's a weird time. We got pandemics, we got viruses going around, we got people mad about everything ever, always. People are on social media. John, that's my name. John, just like that girl screamed earlier, just like her. John, I can't believe you're playing Winter Jam in the middle of a pandemic. Are you trying to kill people? I want everybody to know here tonight, I'm not trying to kill anybody. We're happy. That was supposed to be funny. Thanks for that. You can tweet that. John said, we're not trying to kill anybody. We're having a party at Winter Jam's what we're doing. Everybody knows Russia has invaded Ukraine. We don't know what's going to happen. We have no guarantees of what the rest of this year is going to look like. You see, I think it's always been hard, always, to be a teenager. I think it's a lot harder to be a teenager today than when I was growing. How many parents say you are glad that you are not a teenager right now? I'll tell you that. Do me a favor. If you are a teenager, put your hands up. I love you. Come on. Put them up. Put them up. Look at these beautiful people up in here. I'll tell you what, teenagers, this is my favorite group of people in the whole world. I love teenagers. I do. I love you people. And that is why Skillet and Winter Jam, you're the reason we're here tonight. Because I think that we need, I want to say we, I mean us parents, us pastors, us youth pastors, we need to do a better job of protecting all of these teenagers from the insanity of the world that they grow up in every single day. Here's why I say their world is more difficult. They're being raised in a world right now that lies to them every single day. Every time you open up your phone, you are being lied to. Every time you look at social media, you are being lied to. Especially our young girls. Beauty standards, how you have to look, how you have to act, how you have to talk. Teenage girls, I want you to know, social media is not real, okay? You do not have to live up to any of that stuff. It's a lie. I don't care what news channel you watch, you're being lied to. I don't care what politician, you see this? That's all they do, lie, 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 lie. I don't care what politician you're listening to, they're lying to you. Big media, big tech, lying, college professors. College professors are lying for sure. Rock stars are lying. You hear me? Pop stars are lying. They're all telling these young people there is no such thing as truth. There's no such thing as right and wrong. There's no such thing as morality or immorality. They tell, this is a lie, but they tell these young people, all you need to do is look inside, and whatever feels good to you, that is your truth. That is a lie. Just look inside, do whatever feels good, and whatever you feel has to be true and it has to be right. Now listen up, that is not what the Bible says. That's not what the Bible says. Before I tell you what the Bible says, I want to tell you one other thing that I am not happy about at all. There's also another group lying to these teenagers, and they're lying to them from inside of the church. They have created a false gospel. It is a gospel message that says the same thing as the world does, except with a twist. They say, it's okay if you believe in Jesus, but you don't have to believe that the Bible is true. I want these young people to know tonight, because I love you, that is a lie. That is a lie. Now, let me explain this really quick, you see, because a lot of people say, John, I don't understand. If it's how I feel and it feels so right, then how can it possibly be wrong? I want to tell you this right off. If you've ever felt that way, especially if you're a teenager, if you say, if it's how I feel, then why would God tell me that it's wrong? I'm sorry, I need you to wait for a second. I'm going to finish because I'm ADD and I can't focus on two things. If it's how I feel, then why would God say it's wrong? Number one thing I want to say to you, if that's you. First of all, I want you to know, I understand where you're coming from. I feel you. It's a good question. Here's what I think. I think if Jesus was here right now in the flesh on this microphone, I think he would say something like this to you. First, I think he would say, you know what? I know that it feels right to you. I know that. But you see, child, there is a way that seems right to man, but it brings him death. I know it feels right to you. That's why I came to die on a cross. I know it feels right to you, but it's going to lead you to pain. I know it feels right to you, it's going to lead you to destruction. I know it feels right to you, because even though you don't know it, you are a slave to sin. You're a slave to death. That's the reason I died on the cross, in order to set you free, to give you a brand new heart, to give you a brand new nature. The Bible says this, I was crucified with Christ. I no longer live, but Christ lives in me. I want you to understand tonight that when Jesus sets you free from the power of sin and death, you begin to love new things. And you begin to hate some of the things you used to love. I know it feels right to you. God knows it feels right to you. That's the reason you need Jesus. Because you don't make the rules and I don't make the rules. King Jesus makes the rules because he is the Lord of heaven and earth. So whenever these people come and lie to you and say, you can do whatever you want to do and it doesn't matter because God loves you the way you are, keep living your life. That is a lie. They are trying to keep you in slavery. But Jesus came to set you free. You see, the world lies to you, and they say the only way to be free is to liberate yourself from Christianity. Liberate yourself from the Bible, especially in your sexual life. That's what the world says, isn't it? Liberate yourself from the Bible. Do whatever you want to do sexually, and it'll bring you freedom. That is a lie from the pit of hell. It does not bring you freedom. It brings you further, further, deeper, deeper into slavery, into addiction. But Jesus came to set you free. There is no such thing as freedom outside of Jesus Christ tonight. That's what I want you young people to know. Do not be fooled by people that come and sell a false gospel. I'm going to start preaching if I get too excited. I wrote this book I want to tell you about. It is called Awake and Alive to Truth. I wrote this specifically for teenagers, college students, people of that age. All that this is, parents, youth pastors, all this is Bible theology written in a way that young people can understand why you need Jesus, why Jesus never changes, that Jesus is the rock, things like that, okay? You can check it out at the table. It's in a bundle for $20. You get the book and our brand new album, all right? So check it out if you want. Do you have it? You do have it? Oh, that's free. I thought you said, yeah, you have it. I was like, you like it? You want to read it twice? Is it okay if we play some more music for you tonight? Would that be all right? Do we have anybody here tonight unashamed to say that Jesus Christ is my Lord and Savior? Do we have anybody here tonight to say Jesus is my hero?
Oh,
Could be made.